best of capabilities. With this, let's try to validate what we discussed with some examples, and I'll discuss some of the common open source automation tools that are prevalent in industry these days. So as you can see in the screen, I have mentioned few of the common automation tools which are used in current scenarios. For example, Selenium is one of the common tools, Sahi, Water, Autoit, Sikuli, FlexMonkey. There are few more, but these are few of the most common tools. So with these tools, there are certain limitations, especially in the context of the problems that we discussed as part of our story. What are those limitations? And most of the tools that I have mentioned here are only for web. And if your test case requires interaction with any desktop or Windows component, then these tools are not good enough. In the whole list, Autoit is one of the tools that can be used. So which means if you have a scenario like that, you need a power to combine Selenium with Autoit. Another example is, let's say if you have your test case which requires heavy image comparison, and these days the rich internet applications, there are controls, there are images, there are videos on the page which can only be validated by a good image comparison tool or image comparison utility. Most of the tools lack that, so you'd like to use a specialized tool which is Sikuli, which is one of the best tool as far as image comparison is concerned in the open source world. Another example is if your application or test case requires validation of Flex and Flash component. Now this currently can be handled by a specialized tool like FlexMonkey. So if your base tool is Selenium, you'll have to integrate Selenium with FlexMonkey to handle that kind of scenario. Another interesting challenge that we face, especially with a tool like Selenium. Selenium does not have a very good support with IE. IE executions are damn slow compared to Mozilla or Chrome. So do I have the leverage to run my tests on IE with Water and then run the same script on Mozilla and Firefox with Selenium so that I can use the best of capability of these tools? Currently the answer would be no. If you are using a base framework on top of Selenium or any other specific tool, you won't be able to achieve this. The same problem exists if you are talking about mobile automation space. Again, I have mentioned some of the common tools that are used in current scenarios. These are mostly from open source world, and these tools also have a similar kind of limitation. None of the tools support all platforms. Few are good for Android, few are good for iOS, there are very few for other platforms like Windows 8 or BlackBerry, etc. So it's a tester's nightmare to work with so many tools, where you have to just automate one test case which should be able, and you should be able to run that test case on multiple mobile platforms. Currently it can only be done by creating multiple scripts by utilizing multiple tool sets. So you have a similar kind of limitation in the mobile space as well. So coming back to the business problem that we discussed as part of the story, I would like to take a relook at that problem again and see what are the challenges. So what I am talking about right now is example, real example from a social news broadcasting application. Now as you can see in the diagram, this application is multi-platform. To elaborate it, this application has multiple kind of end users. Some of the users can access the application from web. People who have access to mobile or tablets can access the application from respective mobile devices. There are users like news editors who has a desktop-based interface. Then this application interacts in real time with social popular social applications like Facebook or Twitter, and they send feed to those applications and then also receive feeds from these social media applications. So as you can see, there are multiple, one is that these application, the application that I'm mentioning is multi-platform, plus there are multiple level of integrations involved. And what you see in the diagram is one real example of a business process that needs to be tested. And there are multiple business processes like this. So if I can elaborate this business process, it starts with a mobile where an end user uploads a news video. It goes to editor for approval, and editor has to log into the desktop interface and then approve the item. Once the item is approved, it gets stored in a central database from where it gets published to web. So end user who are logging to the web application or web portal can see the published news content, and at the same time the news content gets feed from the Facebook, so all the likes that are happening, some of the comments that gets posted on Facebook also gets reflected on the web portal. So the test case starts from a mobile platform, it goes to desktop, there is database verification involved, then you need to go and verify on the web, and finally you need to verify a few things by calling web services for the integration of other applications. So based on what we have seen so far, it's quite clear that there is a need. So there are no tools available in the market, especially in open source world, which can handle this business process. If we have to automate this application or automate this business process, what would be the way? I'll have to automate the mobile with a mobile tool like Robotium or Appium, depending on the choice. Then desktop can be automated by Autoit probably. For database, you can use your own VBScript, JavaScript, or SQL scripts. Web can be automated through Selenium or Water or Sahe. Web service again can be automated either through pure Java functions, or if there are complex web services, these can be automated through SOAP UI. So as you can see, we require multiple tools together to test this one business process. So based on what we have seen so far, it's quite clear that there is a need for a platform which can bring multiple tools together and allows you to use specialized capability of a specific tool and still abstracts the user from learning multiple tools. So three things basically: bringing in multiple tools together, allowing the specialized capability of the specific tools, and abstracting the user from interacting directly with the tool. So you need to, what I'm talking about is a common platform for interaction with all the tools at the back end, so that user need not know the tools in detail. The question is, how do we create such a solution? Is it really possible? And if it's possible, what could be a way, what could be a possible architecture, what could be a possible design around it? Following that, I'll also be discussing some of the existing solutions, and I'll also showcase a real implementation of this kind of solution. So before we look into the architectural or design aspect of a solution like this, there are some key points that we need to consider. Now, what are those key points? The first is that this kind of solution has to be tool and technology agnostic. which means we are trying to bring multiple tools together. So this platform needs to be completely tool independent. So today, let's say you are, maybe you are integrating three tools, four tools, but it has to be scalable enough to integrate more tools in future. So it has to be completely tool and technology agnostic. End user abstraction. As I said earlier also, if you are integrating multiple tools, user would like to have a common interface to interact with all the tools. Otherwise, it becomes quite cumbersome and the solution will not be scalable for sure. If we have to make sure that the solution is acceptable to a large section of users, there has to be some kind of abstraction and a common platform provided to users for interaction with the various tools. And finally, scalable, extensible, and adaptable, which means you need, the solution should be flexible enough to integrate more tools if required, because we are talking about specialized capabilities, utilizing specialized capabilities, and if tomorrow there is a new tool which serves a specific purpose, I should be able to use that tool without much of an hassle. So the solution has to be scalable and extensible in that sense. With this fundamental principles in mind, let's look at how to design a solution like this. What can be a possible architecture or a design for this platform, if I can say so. So what I'm going to show right now is a very high level kind of design and architecture that I have in mind. There are various kind of variations that can be used, but the core remains the same. So this architecture that I'm going to showcase is based on certain segregations that we see as part of this solution, and those segregations we call it interfaces. So I'm going to first tell you what are the different interfaces that we require in this kind of platform, and then you will see a holistic view of the overall architecture and design. So the first